It wasn't about singing for me. I didn't want to walk off that stage and rip myself to shreds. I am finding a new level of comfort in my own skin. I'm like, wait a minute. Okay, I stepped out on stage in Rockstar Camp, right? I can do hard things.
I am a woman. Yep, I am an artist. I know where my voice belongs.
I'm here with MJ Impastato. My friend, my colleague, my sister, my confidant, and one of my original graduates from the first ever cohort of Rockstar Camp.
I almost put my fur coat on for you. I did bring some
fabulous
glasses for you. I brag that I lean into my intuition and work through the Akashic Records every day. I've had the pleasure of working with leaders all over the globe.
What had you say yes to getting on stage to sing, even though you're not a trained singer or musician?
Yeah. And you know, we talked about this, but I will absolutely shout it from the rooftops over and over. For me, and this is still true today, that what happened at Rockstar Camp has helped me do all of those things that I was bragging about, right? Have the love of my life, stand in front of leaders from all over the globe, different cultures, different, right, everything, and be able to command the stage.
Mm-hmm. You're such a genius because you said, if I want to get really good at being a leader and living my life without annihilating myself with every breath, one way I could do that is to do the most vulnerable thing possible, right? I'll get on stage in a spotlight and do something I'm not trained to do in public. Like, yeah. And if I can do that and not tear myself apart afterwards, I think I'm onto something. Yeah.
That's right. I just did a delivery last week, with 25 leaders in a room. And, you know, I had to do a coaching demo. It wasn't the best coaching demo on the planet, right? And I could feel myself start to get in that space that we all do.
Right.
Critique and criticize. Okay, great. What can I learn from this?
Right.
And then move on instead of tearing myself to shreds.
I am a woman. Yep, I am an artist. I know where my voice be.
The most powerful thing, and I'm probably going to cry, the most powerful thing for me, and it still is, was the band. And the impact, not only that they had on us, but what we had on them.
Mm-hmm.
Right? We needed each other. And what these guys who are professional musicians play every day, they are subject matter experts at what they do. Right? They can play all of this music in their sleep and we're eking along. I am anyway, right? Like
woo. Everyone is.
And what came out of it, like the day of the performance, I could feel them want this for me so badly. It's powerful. It's powerful. And if it can happen on a stage, right? It can happen in a boardroom.
100%. It is so moving to watch these women in their bodies, having fun, lit up in their joy. They don't even care if it's perfect.
Right.
One of the foundations of this, which I see you living in so many ways, is learning through fun, learning through pleasure, learning in community, learning through outrageousness. And that's what I so loved about you coming back and modeling that for everyone, and how you can hear the whole room is like, wow.
I brag, since Rockstar Camp, I have married the man of my dreams. And I am well pleased. My business is doing better than ever. Oh, and I walked through the airport with this and a fur coat, baby.
Because you're just like, I did this for me.
Yeah.
That's why I walked through the airport like this. Because it was just fun for me.
It's the mindset. It's the ownership. It's, you know, really stepping into the power that we all have. And that's what you encouraged. And you, you know, brought to life for us.
I am a woman. I am an artist. I know where my voice belongs.
Unshakable, constant, never-ending confidence is not a thing for humans. Okay?
No.
But, you know, you can expand it and train it through practice. You know, I always say, like, earn your confidence. Do a thing enough and you will build competence and confidence. But what about the spaces where you don't have experience, competence, practice, and you have to do it anyway? Well, you might not be feeling confident, right? I'm going to sing on stage. Like, am I totally confident? No. But I know I have the tools, the sisterhood, and the support system to do it and survive and return to myself as quickly as possible. It's like what you were saying about teaching. I could see it happening. My coaching demo wasn't great. The critic wanted to flare up, like, oh, there you are. And I know how to dance with it and come back to myself.
We're givers. Mm-hmm. It's so much easier for me to give mm-hmm. or to buy somebody else dinner or to do something thoughtful for somebody else, right? Mm-hmm. It makes me feel good. And I have always said, you know, I say this to my clients. I'm like, if you're always giving and it makes you feel good, right? And they said, yeah. I said, well, you're denying someone else that same pleasure. Yeah. There's so many things that I use from Rockstar Camp in every day. It just happens to be my time in life that I get to really work on, you know, I'm worthy. I have enough. I do enough. I am enough just by being who I am. My goal in life is to help people feel comfortable in their own skin. And you know, Rockstar Camp was a boot camp for me to start feeling that way. I can only help people feel that way if I feel that way myself.
I am an endangered species, but I sing no victim songs. I am a woman.
Yep,
I